Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome back to Gal. So in this video, we're gonna do some cinematic color grading with LUTs on drone aerial shots. Now, LUTs are lookup tables. They're essentially basic math files that you can put on different cinematic profiles for creative looks or to correct the footage. Now, not one LUT fits all. If you apply LUTs and it doesn't really do much to your shot, you're like, what the heck, this is not doing anything. You still have to make further adjustments. You can't expect it to, bam, magically make your shot better. So the shots in the opening are also from Film Supply. Thank you, Film Supply, for providing them for this tutorial. And what's really great is all the filmmakers on there have amazing shots, and you can download the log versions of the files. Now, the LUT pack that I'm using in this video is from Vamify, and it's called Cinematic Drone LUTs, and it has a bunch of different LUTs that you can apply on your video clips to achieve different creative effects. And they're specifically designed for the Mavic drone D-Log footage. And again, if you guys are like, what is a log? What is it? I actually made a whole video on what log footage is and how you can best color grade it. But that said, this pack can also be used with other shots, not only the Mavic. I've tested them out with different types of shots, and you just have to make some adjustments. And it's just a great starting point from which you can then get more creative with your looks. Now, I've put a link to the entire pack in the description box below, and there's also a discount code if you guys are interested. But again, I wanna stress that you guys don't have to buy LUTs. You can make your own, and I have lots of different color grading tutorials, but I really like using LUTs because they kind of add this foundation that I wasn't expecting, or a different perspective. And it could be a great basis for like a film that you're making that can give you an entire look and starting point. So what I've done is I've put time codes in the description box below to everything that I cover. So that way, if you need quick information fast, you can just click on that time code. It'll take you there. I will not be offended if you need to find quick information fast, but I hope that you guys watch and find all of the little lumetri tips that I'm going to give you towards the end of the tutorial. So let's go ahead and jump on in. So we are in Premiere Pro here, and the way you can import Creative LUTs is by going up to the Creative tab inside Lumetri Color, and from Look, there is a drop down, and you can choose Browse. Now this way you can import one at a time. Let's choose Forest Clean and open that up. You can see, voila, it applies a new color grade. Now some adjustments need to be made. Now the reason why I'm using Creative and not the Basic Correction LUT is because there is an intensity slider. So you can move this slider to the left to blend it with the original more, or you can make it even more intense. So we can make some adjustments here. We wanna get this Luma waveform over here on the left as close to 100 as possible. It doesn't have to be all the way up there, just until you can see that it's not gonna get clipped. So I'm gonna go down here to curves, and we're just gonna move this curves over until it brightens up the image. And that's looking pretty good. Now, this was just importing one LUT at a time. Let's say we wanted to go in and try out many different LUTs from a pack, and you don't want to have to go in and go to Creative and from the drop down hit Browse and then select a new one. What you can do is you can bulk add them to your application support folder. So I'm on a Mac, but if you guys are on a PC, I'll put the folder path for PCs as I do this. So I'm going to go to Finder, and then from this new Finder window, go to go to folder, and then hit go to library. And this is where you're going to click on application support, Adobe, then common. In here, you're going to create a folder called LUTs. So control click, I'm going to create a new folder, LUT, and then lowercase s. And within this folder, we can create two more folders, one for the technical LUTs, which goes under the basic correction tab of Lumetri Color, and one for creative, which goes under the creative tab. So all of the LUTs in this folder will appear in the creative tab. So let's go ahead and create these two, technical and creative. All right. Then I can go to the Mavic LUTs from Vamify, take all of these cube files, which are the LUT files, and I will drag these into the Creative folder. And then they are here. But we can't just go over to Creative and see them here. You see that they're not here. We actually have to restart Premiere Pro. So I'm going to hit save, Command S to save this. And we just have to wait until Premiere Pro opens again.
One eternity later.
So now that Premiere Pro is open, let's go to this next shot here. And if we wanted to choose a LUT to test out, now when we go to Creative and we go to the dropdown, you can see all of the different LUTs here, which is great. So you can just go in and like quickly select one until you find one that works. So let's try the gray matter. And then we can make some adjustments. We can increase the vibrancy. That's looking pretty good. We can adjust the curves to increase the brightness. And that's looking good. And the contrast at the bottom of the Luma waveform. We don't want it to go all the way down to zero though, because we don't want it to clip. And so if we like that, we can leave it as is. So you can click on the effects, toggle on or off to see the before and the after. Now, another LUT over here, let's say we wanted to apply a different LUT to this clip. So this clip is super cool. I love this shot. I wish I was this guy on the motorcycle right now. Let's try a different LUT. Let's try the City Flat Nevada. And you can see it needs a lot of work. It's pretty dark in this shot, and we can increase or reduce the intensity here depending on our liking. I'm going to increase it, and don't worry, I will bring in more detail in just a second. Let's make it around 115. And then let's increase the vibrancy to around 50. Just type that in there. And now let's go up to Basic Correction, and here we can use the shadows and move that slider to the right to bring back in more detail. Look at that. Looks so much better. And then we can go down to curves and add even more exposure. Bring that up. And we can add a little bit of contrast, just slightly. We don't want too much contrast because then we'll lose a little bit of detail on the road. So that's looking good. Now we can go down to hue versus sat and hue versus hue. So we can use the dropper tool here to select the sky, and I want to increase the saturation of the sky. I'm going to select that, and we can move these keyframes over, and we can just boost up the saturation. Look at that. So now it's far more vibrant in the sky. And if we wanted to make it more of a golden hour, we can go down here to hue versus hue, and we can select this hue, and then we can just boost it up just a tad to make it a little bit more pink. See the before and after? Now that's looking a lot better. I love that. And now what we can do, if we wanted to copy these attributes over to this clip, we just hit Command C on a Mac, Control C on a PC to copy that. And then right over here on this clip, control click and paste attributes and just paste Lumetri color attributes. And now you see it's not perfect, but it's starting to look better. We can actually turn on comparison view and we can use this shot as the reference and this shot as our current time head here. And what we can do, we can see that it's clipping in this shot. It's way too bright up here. So what we can do is go to curves and move this over so that way it's not as bright and it's not clipping. And we can go to basic correction and let's reduce the highlights slightly. And then from color wheels and match, Adobe has a color matching tool, but you'll see what happens. It's not exactly perfect. Let's hit apply match. And it's going to analyze the reference shot and apply the color on the right. Now it just takes a few moments to do that, and you can see it just looks too red. So I'm going to hit Command Z to undo that. So instead of doing that, just think, okay, the sky is the highlights and I want to change the highlights to be more orange. So over here is the highlights wheel. I can move this highlights up just slightly, ever so slightly, just to get more of that sun reflection in the highlights to kind of match the sky over there. So that is a cool way that you can match different shots. Now, if you want to color grade entirely from scratch, let's just get out of comparison view. If you want to make your own LUTs, you can certainly do that as well. For example, this shot here was not a Mavic drone. In none of the LUTs, if I did the drop down here, none of these LUTs really looked that good. So that's okay though, because I'm going to quickly show you how you can color grade and save your own LUT now. So in this case, this shot here, it's pretty flat. It's a log shot. So what we first want to do is increase the brightness of the Luma waveform and decrease it to add more contrast. So let's go to the Luma curve line here and move it over to the left. And we're going to get it closer to 100 just to brighten this up. And then we will bring this curve at the bottom as far right as possible until it looks good. We don't want it to get too dark, especially in this mountain right here. So that's looking a lot better. We can already see the before and the after. That's looking good. And if you like this shot, you could leave it as is, but we definitely want to add in some vibrancy. I always like to add a little bit more color boost. See that? No, that's too much. Just add a little bit. And then using our handy curves again, we can change the hue. So here, if we use the dropper tool and just click on the sand, and then using hue versus hue, we can actually change the color to be a little bit more pinkish in color. So here's the before and after. After it's more pink, before it's a little bit kind of yellow. So let's turn this back on, and then we can increase the saturation of this hue. Select this area again. We can boost this up just slightly, and we can kind of scrub through, and we don't want it to be too pink there. So let's drop this hue versus hue down a little bit. And yeah, we're starting to get our grade here. And so you can see the before and the after. And, you know, I'd probably tweak this a little bit more, but if you wanted to save this as a LUT file, a .cube file, just go up to the hamburger menu and export it as a cube file. And you can just save this as whatever you want to call it, say desert LUT, and you want to save it to your computer, and then you can share it with your buddy, your editor, another colorist, and so that's how you can make a LUT. So that's all for LUTs in this video today. I hope you guys found the tutorial useful, and thanks to Vamify for sponsoring. Again, their link is in the description box below if you guys are interested in the pack with the discount code. And if you guys have any other questions about LUTs, how to grade, anything that's itching at you that you're like, oh, I really want to know how to use color wheels and match or HSL secondary, what the heck are those? Just leave a comment below and maybe I'll make a tutorial about it. So that's it for this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!